pleasure.
Montana State University researchers want to use a unique method to age sharptail eggs during the nesting season.
By floating the eggs, you can, in theory, figure out how old the nest is. So say we find a nest, it has 15 eggs. We have no idea when she laid the eggs, and we can figure out when it's supposed to hatch. So we can then come back and monitor it when she's hatching.
Milligan and her crew, as part of a study looking at grazing systems' impacts on sharp-tailed grouse, spent every day tracking radio-tagged female sharptails.
She's right there.
Through the nesting season.
If we have this curve, you could track these birds less intensively or less often, so you wouldn't have to be tracking it every day to know when it started and then to know when it's going to hatch.
When first laid, an egg will lay on its side in water, but as the chick develops and an air sac forms, the egg will gradually stand upright and rise, eventually above the waterline when the chick is ready to hatch.
So 36 is the angle.
This curve will make it easier to monitor nest success, which is a vital component in maintaining healthy sharp-tailed grouse populations.
Nest survival and chick survival are two of the parameters that have some of the greatest impact on overall population dynamics. So it's important to look at what's affecting those parameters to see what's influencing the population as a whole.
Floating eggs will allow researchers to be more efficient and learn more about sharp-tailed grouse. But it is still just one piece in the broader effort to conserve this prairie bird. I'm Winston Greeley, out among Montana's fish, wildlife, and parks.